Hello, Computer People. This is Kaas more or less official Twitch stream, volume 1. First things first, please tell me if you can.
Hello, Computer People.
Oh, I'll. This was a latency test, of course. So, this is Raspbian, which is a standard Raspberry Pi Linux distribution. And today we will try to implement a car target for this thing. So, this is all new for me, will be a little adventure. Maybe it will work out, maybe it won't. And I didn't do a lot of preparations. I downloaded some stuff. And the one thing I already did is I compiled all the binary tools which are part of Car for the ARM CPU architecture so I can run them on the Pi. But that's all. So can everybody understand me? Two comments so far, evening and hi. I'm not sure what they mean in regards to the audio quality. Anyway, I'll just start here. You may or may not know, Car has a sister project called Core. This one right here. Car is implemented in Hex, Core is implemented in C++, and that's the biggest difference. And for any native C++ targets, Car just forwards all calls to Core. Oh, my SOC must be really good. I don't use a SOC. I have an emergency SOC right next to me. But right now I don't use it. Okay, so because Raspberry Pi will be a C++ target, really all we have to do today is inside Core and not inside Car. We will, of course, at the end, if we get that far, test if Car works with the new Core backend, but all of our actual work will be inside of Core. So, first thing to do, we have to add a new target to Core Make. And Core Make is in Core Tools, Core Make, surprisingly. And it's a bunch of JavaScript files because it's a Node.js tool. And we have exporters for different IDEs and other stuff like for make files. And we have somewhere, platform.js. We will add a new one in here. Let's call it Pi. So, halfway done, almost. Let's see, open this up. Somewhere there has to be a switch block for the targets. Not in here. Then it'll be in here. So, that's just for text output. Not very exciting, but I'll fill it in. So, this one is kind of important. This switches the default graphics backend depending on the platform backend. So for Windows, it by default uses D3D9, but has a lot of other options. Let's see, we put it at the end. Case platform Pi. We use ESSL, which is the GLSL dialect for OpenGL ES. So this is not exactly about the backend. This is, here we have it, about the shader language. So compile shader might do the right thing then. Okay, and somewhere it has to pull in the exporter libs somewhere around here. So we will do the same thing we do for Linux. After all, this is a Linux system, just with some specialties, it seems. Form.py. Okay. One more thing we have to do in CoreMake, or one more thing I remember to do. We have to make sure CoreMake runs the correct binaries for ARM here. For ARM, I called them graphics Linux ARM. For now, I will just do a little hack so I don't have to have a look into the Node.js documentation, because I'm lazy like that. Return ARM Linux ARM. So that might just work. Too far. Next one, the core file for core itself. So this is a build file that defines how core is built. When you create a core project, you write a core file yourself, which then pulls in core's core file. Questions? Hardcore development in a notepad? Yes, it is. But it's better than Windows Edit. It supports Linux line ends. This is a Pi 3, but it still runs in 32-bit mode, because there is, as far as I know, no 64-bit Raspbian yet. Okay. So the core file has a large if-else block to switch the platforms. And we will create a new one based on the Linux if block. So this will pull in the Pi backend, which we still have to implement. Pi does not yet support Vulkan, so we take that out. OpenGL is correct for this one. I'll go ahead and add a Pi define. SysPy. Okay, and that's it in here. Okay. Also, I want to fix the one hack I did after all, so I can check this in. That was in here. So, OS R. Let's look up the Node.js documentation. I missed an E. Oh, I'll get back to that in a moment. Thank you. Continue to please point out every mistakes I make. Ah, that easy, huh? Can't see my keyboard because of the microphone. Looks all right, I guess. So, I missed an E. What did I? Probably in here, huh? Ah, there it is. Everything fixed. Another mistake. Thanks, Nadako. So you see, programming on a video stream is highly efficient. You can't do any bugs. So I'll just do something really bad. I'll just check this code in and pull it in an actual core project. Okay, Graffiti didn't really change, Cormac changed. And that goes. Okay. The core application I usually start with when I implement a new backend is the Shader Core application. So let's pull in the changes. And now we're getting crazy. We try to. No, we don't. We don't. We do one more thing because we before we try to run Cormac. Shader core. Core. Backends. We create a directory for the backend. And we copy the Linux backend because why not? Can I do that here? Copy, paste. Okay, Pi Backend, right here. Won't need these. Yes, trash it. Might need all the other stuff. Okay, so we will rewrite the Linux backend for Pi. And now, maybe it will work. I have a copy of Node here, one dir up. Core make Pi. What will happen? Creating Pi project files. Build directory. Doesn't look too bad. That's a code blocks file. Hopefully. Let's see. Okay, here it is. Let's see if we can load the project in Shader Core, build shader test. Looking good. Okay. That's the code we have to rewrite. We can probably just keep the threading code. Mutex. Sound. I have no idea about sound. Does Pi use ALSA? R sound? Maybe. Maybe not. We will find out. Mouse. Yes, that we probably have to rewrite too. Okay. So let's take all the X window stuff because we won't use that. Because I hope that is true, but I read that on the internet. When you want to do a OpenGL application for Pi that doesn't fall back to software mode, you don't use X windows. So we will do a special Pi thing instead. That is gone. We keep the sound, maybe it'll just compile, maybe not. And we take out all the stuff in the system CPP, which is all the stuff to start up the backend, basically. X open. Create window. That will likely have a very different implementation. Okay. Out. So that's the new multi-window stuff from Dave. No idea what I have to change there. Handle messages. Currently handles X window events, so out. Mr. Lepton informs us it uses ALSA, so we will see. X make current, probably not. Ah, that is multi-window stuff. I'll send the Pi to Dave so he can also implement the multi-window stuff for Pi. Swap buffers, that is. Mighty important. Okay. For now, let's hack it. 1080. Mm. 1920. 1080. Pressed some F key accidentally and oh, something. Aha. Something is happening. Guess it tried to compile. Where am I? Here. Okay, the timing stuff down here should probably just work. Let's see, there's in the... Ah, ugly, my code blocks export doesn't pull in header files. So, what I wanted to do right now is in the OpenGL backend, there's one header file, this one. Okay, doesn't work like that. This one works. So, this pulls in the correct OpenGL headers because for some reason that's completely different on just about every system. So, let's see how that works on the Pi. One important thing you should do when you implement a new backend, wait for somebody else to try, so he can write some text so you can see where you have to can look up everything. Raphael tried to implement a Pi backend before. And if I remember correctly, he got it basically working, apart from some OpenGL problems, which we might run into too later. But he deleted his stuff accidentally, so we have to do everything again. But we still have this GitHub issue where Raphael and Makenbot listed a bunch of stuff they found out, and more importantly, here's a link to a tutorial about how to do OpenGL on the Pi. And when that, here it is. Let's use that. So, how do you pull in the OpenGL headers when you are on the Pi? Nobody knows. Let's try to do what Linux does first. Okay. If dev versus pi, then we don't get the X headers. We don't define this, or do we? I don't know. I'll keep it out for now. DNX, I don't think so. But this might work. So, let's see. We try to compile, because why not? Okay, doesn't work. Let's see if we can find some sample code. Hello, Pi. Hello, Triangle. Sounds nice. Triangle. I take this. Thank you. Can I? Did I copy it? Okay. Such a pity. Probably have to add some include directory. So let's see, is there a make file? Make file includes a make file. Some flex. Includes opt. Okay. Let's copy some stuff. And we will put it not in here. I'm getting hints in the chat. Excellent. Oh, sorry. I hit my microphone. Still working. It's a little... one moment. Oh, I guess it's okay again. What did I want to do? Include directories. Core file. Something like this. Opt VC include. Let's see. Let's open another one. Okay, back into code blocks, reload project, and build again. No such file or directory. Build options. Batch directories. Other options, defines, no. Maybe properties. Oh, doesn't look like it. Maybe when I click this one. Linker settings. We'll have to change that a little. Here they are. My build system didn't recognize that that's a global directory, not a local directory. Let's change it here for now. Pulled in some stuff. Video Core OS abstraction layer. Guess I'll have to add more include directories. Let's get those global ones. And put them in here for now. Add one. And this one. More hints in the chat. One moment. Let's try this first. That looked a lot better. GL frame buffer binding not defined. Do we even need that? Kind of. We can fix this. And not defined syspy. Obviously, I need an OpenGL ES defined to clean things up a little. But that looks scary. Why is that one not defined? I don't like that. That I understand that is I have OpenGL ES. Why is that not defined? Where's my favorite development tool? Here it is. That defined. No, should be in that header file, I guess. Yes. That should help. Yes. But still, why is this one not defined? I have no idea. Because this is very, very basic stuff for shaders to work. Basic OpenGL ES2 stuff. Pulls in this one. Is there maybe... Do they maybe differentiate OpenGL ES 1 and 2? Let's have a look inside this directory. That has to be in... what was it? Opt-vc include. Oh, let's use this. Include. Ah, ha, ha, ha. Okay. That is the thing we have to change. GLES. 2 GL 2. No old school OpenGL here. We don't want that. We are not that old. Ah, another one of those hacky old things. Oh, look at that. Aha, aha. That is some new stuff. Who did write this? Got a report yesterday that iOS doesn't compile anymore because of this, I think. So if aha, that might help. Oh, but this one seems to be defined for some reason. Aha. Oh, and why didn't iOS work then? Have to look at that later. Let's change that. Open GL. Yes. What was it? Yes. No, it was okay. Out. Aha. Okay, still not working. But we don't need that. That is for, I think, creating frame buffers with a dev buffer attached. Mm-hmm. beautiful code, right? It's excellent. What? What is this? This makes no sense. Okay. Out. Why? Out. Aha. No alpha. Or do I have to include another directory? Okay, sound later, maybe even not today. I'll take all of this out. Don't do it. I might have to install libalsadef, yes, but I'll try that later. Okay, some X window stuff I missed. You go, all of this has to go. GLX context has to go as well. Bye bye. This I think is X window stuff too. Okay. Let's see. GL boolean. Let's get this one. Really? Like this. No multi-window support for now. One window. Always return the same nonsense. Ten 80 and can I keep that? I guess window handle null pointer. Okay. Pi. Almost missed that one. File does not name a type. Is that... What is this? Looks like I accidentally pasted in some crap into the file. Okay, the shader sample is not up to date, but we can fix that. Ah, the one from right now, the weird file reference happened when I tried to drop the file into code blocks. So don't do that. But what do we do here? This one is gone. And how does it even work now? Let's look it up in car. Because that runs core. Car. Backends. Core. So this is the code that pulls in core into car when you use a native target. So, random, we don't need that. Core system set name, core system setup. Fancy. Okay. Let's grab some stuff. Let's paste some stuff. We will need this one, but not this, not this, not this, not this. No. Set name, shader, set up. This we don't need, I think. Options. Ta 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 ta. Okay. 1024, 768. Title. Shader. X, epsilon. Let's put in some nonsense values. Always fun. Anti-aliasing. Guess I can set that to 0. Or maybe 1. 1 might make more sense. I'll keep it at 0. Or maybe it's just true and false. Window mode. We will see. Maybe. Okay, lessons learned today. Keep your sample code up to date. Oh. Oh. Ah, that's the window ID now. Can I not? Let's fix this in core. Where are we? We're not here. Shader Core. Core Sources. Core. Graphics. Graphics. Begin. Where is it? Here it is. Aha. Much nicer, right? Let's see. Oh, pity. System Impel, really? Do I? Let's see. What's in here? This is looking good, I think so. Zero, I guess. This one I have to look up. Orientation. Window options, where are they? Window.h. Window.h. Window mode, window. Like this. Like. It's in enum class. Oh, that's some fancy new C++ whatever thing I'll probably take out again. So we can compile it on older hardware, but this looks like it will work for now. App was not declared. Oh, let's see how that works now. System start. Let's do it. No. Okay. It compiled, but didn't link, right? Multiple definitions of whatever. Desktop bits. Aha. So that's another thing that changed. So I guess that also broke the Linux backend. Did anyone try that recently? Be gone. Window width, window height. Okay. Yeah, now we are at the linking stage. Okay. Now we have to figure out the correct linking options. Let's close down all the weird files. Okay. L. This stuff, I guess. Let's also just put it in here temporarily. So, out. I don't remember what the L was, but I think some very basic Linux stuff, which probably also works here. So. Okay. Let's build. Pity. More fancy build options to do. Let's see, that's probably in here. Here it is. But it doesn't link, which probably means I have to add that here. This one in here. Okay. Not that bad. Aha. Oh, that's a little ugly. Clue is a little library I use inside Core to pull in all the newer OpenGL functions. And I probably don't even need that on the Pi, so I will take it out, I guess. GL clue. And everything I do in here in code blocks, I will later have to probably add to CoreMake so it works right away when we create a new project. But for now, do the fast thing. How can I even remove file for project? Okay. Next try. Whatever that is. Enum display monitors. Some of the new stuff. Do I need that right now? Enum display monitors. What is it supposed to do? How did that happen? Okay. Don't ever, unless you know what you do, click the middle mouse button in code blocks. Seems to paste. What do we do about that? Does it? Display counter. Displays. Let's implement it somehow. Core display. This is the wrong file. This one. So, display counter, I guess. Let's say 1 for now. I didn't yet add BCM host, but we'll get to that. I didn't even add code to create a window, so still stuff to do. But wasn't it? What's all this stuff doing here? Out of my way. Okay. Let's use this crappy syntax. This like this, like this. No errors, 3 warnings, no return statement in function returning non void in function create window. Can I see where that is? No. Create window. Do I have a search function? Oh, create window? No. Window. Create window. Whatever. When in doubt, just return 0. Almost always works. Double buffer defined but not used, that's okay. Fatal error defined but not used, I think that's okay too. Okay. It links but it doesn't do anything because we don't actually open a window yet. So let's grab some more code. Yes, indeed, there is no SDL in Core or Car. I want to add an SDL backend because that's, as far as I know, required for Linux Steam games. But for Pi, I don't think we will need that. Oh, do we still have our browser? Yes. Yes. This one, using the display directly. Import BCM host, really? I don't think so. Okay. We will include that, we won't import that, we are not in Apple land. Okay, let's just include it and see what we have to do to make the include work. Are we here? No. Let's close this one. Include and we opt VC include. I think we already added that. So normally for global files you use those. Although it doesn't make much of a difference really. Okay. Got that one. And VCM host to linker flags. Is that Did they do that? Yes. BCM host. Oh, what is this stuff? Who knows? Okay. Here, when you're in code blocks, remember to go up to the global options, project options, because that is where Cormac puts everything. Add some stuff. See if it still links. Yeah. Change something just because why not? And it's still linking. Okay. Now we can actually start to add Py specific code, I guess. Maybe we should commit what we did because we know what happened to Raphael. Huh? Don't want to happen that to us. Maybe the Py might explode. I read about it getting hot. Is it hot? Let's see. No, it's okay. Nothing burning down here yet. Did we change something in Cormac? I think we did. We didn't. Okay. But we changed something in here. Okay. I take all of it. We are safe. Nothing can go wrong now. And I don't add this shader files because those are the compiled shaders, which should actually go into the ignore file. Okay, about 1 hour in, and we didn't yet do anything of substance. Anyway, let's have a closer look at that. Dispman X, that is either a new superhero with a new movie coming out next year, or it's maybe short for Display Manager X something. We will never know. Get display size, tra-la-la. Final tasks. EGL create Windows Surface, EGL create this, that. Let's look at some sample code instead. Makefile, we're done with that. Hello, triangle. So, copyright, Broadcom. Those are the guys who will sue me next week. Okay. Init OGL. That sounds useful. Choose one pick. This man is back. So, is that does that sets the display, OpenGL context and screen stuff. Does that also create a window for us? Init model project, that's not interesting at all. Neither is this. Neither is this. And this is totally exciting. Or maybe not. Just standard OpenGL stuff. This one we will need. Because this one is mighty important. So I don't think we will create a state structure. We will just dump everything in the global variable space, because why not? Init textures, that is just standard OpenGL. Load text images, reads in the file, standard stuff. Exit func, I don't care, I'll just. Aha. PCM host init, init OGL. Okay. This is the stuff you have to do. It's the stuff we don't have to replicate, because it's just standard OpenGL stuff. And this is where we just cut the power off. PCM host init. Let's do it. So SDL question, I think I already answered that. Yes, that's on the backlog. And middle mouse button, yes, but I also talked about that already. Is this being recorded? Yes. It's being recorded on Twitch, because there's one thing you have to activate for it to be recorded. And yes, I'm also recording it locally, and actually in 1080p. So if you want to watch it later, watch it on YouTube, because it will look a little better than it looks now on the Twitch stream. Because my upstream is not sufficient for more than 720p. What was I even doing? Ah, I think I remember. Init window, is it? Create window. We paste in all the stuff here. And we hope this is still called. Yes, I think so. PCM host init. Let's Google this. What is this even doing? Aha, video core APIs. Contains a Broadcom video core. Oh, that's why we ended up at some Broadcom sample code thing. Okay. Hardware accelerated. OpenEGL, whatever. OpenMax, that is for video decoding, right? Maybe, I think. Media application, yes. OpenVG is for vector graphics, but never looked into it. So, 24 gigaflops, so we can do anything. That will probably get us a lot of bunnies on the screen. We got that. This looks like actual documentation, which is nice. Required that the blah 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 is called first. We can do that before calling any of the VC functions. Corresponding VC whatever init functions, da 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 da. This man is back. Linking against, we already did that. Graphics get display size. Ooh, protcom specific function, okay. Hello Triangle is a built-in sample program. Comes with sample. Aha, aha, aha. Is that the same one we found online? Maybe, maybe not. Paste and go, cool. Oh, Hello Triangle 2. Hello Triangle, Hello Tiger. Same stuff, maybe? Maybe? Yes! It looks similar. Aha! So we finally found out where the internet is located on our local machine. Mm-hmm. What is Hello Triangle 2? Ah, I think this one uses OpenGL ES2 instead of 1, and this is actually the stuff we will need. Uh-huh. Good thing we just stopped and searched around for no reason. Init OpenGL and in terminate. We don't need that. We don't terminate stuff. We don't even want to build that into our programs. We know what could happen. But this one we already called. Now let's grab the init code. But maybe first have a look into the license. Must retain copyright notice. Ta ta ta. So standard MIT license, I think. Okay, I'll take the code. I'll change it until nobody will recognize where it comes from, and nobody of you guys will tell anyone. Okay? Okay. Oh. Success. Let's grab some code. Yeah, I think we will pretty much need all of it. Bam, efficient programming. Okay, needs one more space. A tragedy. Fix that later. Or can I... Ah! Aha! It works. High tech. Code blocks is cool. Success. Check, I have some other function instead of check for the double. Yes, that's in. I have some OpenGL checking function somewhere. Where's my GL stuff? GL check errors. Let's use that. Mm-hmm. Third state, wirklich tritt auf state. Der Broadcom will never catch us. It will all look so different. Check, check, check. Everything checked. So, state display, what is it? What does it do? Okay, no new questions. Can continue doing whatever, copying stuff. Okay. So we at least put it in an anonymous namespace, so it doesn't show up. Oh. In other C files. So, don't need no state object. State, we need no comments, nobody needs comments. Right, right. State, go away. No state. We do functional programming, we have no state. No state. Complete globalization, we use no states. Screen width, screen height. Is this stuff going full screen in the end? Maybe always, and we can't have a window? Might that be the case here? State, state, no state. Surface. No state, no comments, which what does it even say? Connect the context to the surface. Yeah, be gone. We need screen width, screen height. Oh, what does that do? Source rect, distract. I'm distracted by the distract. Display element, screen width, screen height. What do they use? U in 32. We do that too. And we will use it, we will use it. Did I push the middle mouse button? I did. Here, I forgot what it's called. Screen width. Screen width. Screen height. Okay. Let's build. Oh, pity. What can we do? Yeah, no state. Didn't I tell you? Invalid. Oh my goodness. Is that C? Yeah. This happens from time to time when you port code from C to C++, because C++ is a little more proud about its types than C is. From int to this man x transport t. What is the int? Can I go to definition? Let's see. Find declaration. That would be useful. Find them. Let's see. Ah, of course not. Of course not. That's highly sophisticated functionality. This man x protection none. Is this? This one. Let's cast wildly. This man x, and can this be? No. I think, oh, look at that. About once or twice in a year, there's a comment that's actually useful. Let's cast this one. Hello, this man x transform t. You could definitely make a movie about this one. Build it. More state. We don't like state. It compiled. Do we want to try and run that? What will happen? You think so? I'm not so sure about that. What will happen? Is it full screen? Will it go full screen? Will it go full screen and I can't exit? Maybe that will happen. Maybe the system will crash. I will try. I use the build and run button. Ah, no OpenGL device context is set. Could not open file. Okay, could not open file. That's probably because we are not running in the proper directory. But no OpenGL device context is set. Where does it happen? Questions? No questions. Very good. Device context. That is probably. It's probably printed inside that check error function, which I can't find like that because it's called everywhere. Ah, here it is. Aha. I think that's just some random function we didn't implement. Current device, what does that even do? I don't know. Current device. Current device ID. Set current device ID. Make current. Do we need that? Do we or do we not? Let's just ignore the error message, like the pros do it. And let's see why I couldn't load the shader file. build options, properties. Where's the local directory? Shouldn't that be set up automatically? I thought it was. Looks like I'm wrong. Let's see here. Oh, where do I set that? Platforms, all, exactly. Make file, don't need that. Execution, dear. clicking harder, doesn't work. File. Okay. Ah, is that execution directory for the makefile? I don't care about that. Precompiled headers. By the way, that's something I should finally add. Will make building C++ much, much faster. Don't even know if regular, does anybody know, does regular HXCPP builds use precompiled headers? Do they? But where is my regular output file name? Execution work. That's all right. Then why doesn't it work? Deployment. Here are the compiled shader files. And looks good actually. Maybe we have to add some code in the IO namespace. File reader. Ah, a little secret. Why is this file called filereader-winrt.cpp? That's a little hack I implemented because Windows Universal Apps are super weird. They compile, how to explain that? They basically implemented some special dialect of C++ and you use that to access the Windows Universal blah blah APIs. And most C++ code works in that mode. Compiled hex code and the standard HXCPP headers tend to not work so great with those changes Microsoft did to C++. So what I did is I built into CoreMake when the file ends with winrt.cpp, it and you're building a Windows Universal app, then it builds it in this Microsoft C++ mode. Else, it doesn't. And that gets rid of a lot of problems when you use Windows Universal la la la. So, but this is the one file in Core which I still haven't split off into the backend directories, which is littered with ifdefs. Just like everything in HXCPP, by the way, but I didn't say that. Do we have to? Ifdefs with Linux. We will have to do the exact same thing that Linux does. So let's make something really bad. Let's say ifdef syspy define sys Linux. This will only apply to this C++ file. This thing doesn't execute in other files. So, and this might just work. Or was that actually already defined because I have that in my build system? We will see. Deleting void is undefined. Who cares? Oh, change to full screen mode. I don't know what's happening. It's all black. Oh, did we start a space game? Actually, what it should do is it should show a red triangle for half of the screen. But at least it doesn't crash. But what now? How can we end this program? Is there a shortcut like in Windows? Ah! Alt F4 works. We're lucky. But oh, stuff runs, just doesn't do anything meaningful. How, when this, if this can only work in full screen mode, how do I get any debug output? Ugly, ugly stuff. Let's think about that while we commit our changes. CD core. Okay. Still have no idea what to do. So, is this actually the case? Can hardware accelerated OpenGL only run full screen on the Pi? Does anybody know that? I think this one worked in a window, didn't it? Oh. Is that hardware accelerated? I would guess it is. But actually, with Minecraft's graphic style, you can't really tell. Is this OpenGL or is that hardware OpenGL or software OpenGL? Who knows? Not that many polygons, really. Okay, let's stop programming and play Minecraft. Or how do I end this? Oh. That one runs in the window. Oh, sorry, stream started dropping. When I started my black full screen application or when I started Minecraft? Let's see. Documentation. Something. Sometimes it's helpful. Ah, with the black screen. Okay. It probably changed the display mode and confused my HDMI grabber. Maybe. So, full screen mode is so not helpful when you're developing stuff. RW. Hier. So. Native window sounds like a window. Is it because maybe choose config. What does it do? Bind API, create context, get display size, display open. Okay, this of course is the size of our screen, which it shouldn't be when we want to run in window. But still, it didn't look like a big window, it looked like a full screen mode. Let's just try to put in something else here. Something nice. Nobody needs higher resolutions than that anyway. Okay. Be ready for a dropped stream again. Okay. Looks interesting. It's not a red triangle, though. Okay. Let's read more docs. Let's read this. Maybe. Surprisingly sophisticated video core. That sounds okay. Nice implementation of OpenGL. Sounds okay too. Exciting. Yes, the last test was exciting. Small hurdle. Traditional way. Maybe we should have just tried that, but the things I read, I think from, I don't know where, is that this still is not resolved? I don't know. But it's more fun doing a custom backend anyway, right? Yes. Friggle on GitHub knows what to do, maybe. Where's my Friggle? Using the display directly. Sadly, that sounds like full screen mode. Temporary solution. Connection, hardware pipe. Okay, we did all of that. Ah, maybe. Just put in this one here, and maybe we have to put it in here too. Let's
go back.
Let's do something else. U int 32 t screen width. Let's hide the globals and set this one. Okay, build, compiles, okay, black screen, maybe, green, very, very black. Black. Why is it black? What can we do? We got the swap buffers call. And if I set a breakpoint in here, it will... but I don't think that will work like I want it to work. Can I get a console up? Do I have to write into a file to even see what's going on? Can I connect a second display? Probably not. EGL default display. Yes. Let's Google. Raspberry Pi OpenGL window. Which will probably show me stupid links because it finds X windows without X windows. Getting a native windows does. Let's open that. And search for in a window. In a window. If you want to run in a window, you will need to build with SDL1. That is not helpful. Hardware 3D in a window. Demo. That sounds like it. Proof of concept. Oh, in an X window. Aha. 16-bit mode. I took this code. Oh my. Okay. I don't think we want to do that. It's powered by the hardware's DMA functionality. Also. Okay, maybe not quite as low as it sounds, but... Okay. So it looks like hardware 3D in a window is actually a problem on the Pi. And you can somehow do that with XWindow, but I don't think we will implement that today. But I will save this bookmark. I save a bookmark for this. Add bookmark. So, but that kind of confirms maybe that with the regular OpenGL Pi code you can only run full screen, which makes everything super difficult for us. So, remote debugging would be great, but setting that up would probably take me an hour, I don't know. Okay. Any hints in the chat, maybe? I should be able to use part of the screen. Ah, maybe part of the screen without a window, but just as an overlay. Is that what you mean, Mr. Gepato? Ah, of course you don't get UI. Yes, I don't care about UI. I just want my debugger to work somehow. And debug messages and stuff. Printf, it's awesome thing. Use alpha? Ooh, okay. That is kind of crazy. Let's see if we can. Use alpha. Let's close all others. So, what does it actually do? Sets a vertex buffer. Draws a triangle. And this is a clear call. When we don't clear to zero, and instead, will it find this? Ah, wow, wonderful. Okay, I will clear color. R, G, B, A. It already clears to alpha zero. So it should already be transparent if the OpenGL implementation would use the alpha channel of the back buffer, which usually does not happen. What else can we do? Screen width is now something small. Let's make sure it's actually something small. Exciting black graphics. I feel like I'm stuck. What a pity. This man X has alpha. It's this man's return. This? Because this is already set. This man has alpha. This man has alpha. More this man stuff. More hints? Half of the screen as a transparent surface, that would be excellent. If we could pull that off somehow. But how? We see this man X element at. It's the second time today that that a comment is actually helpful. Let's look this thing up properly. Who? Maybe I will change my way today and in the future add comments myself. But probably not. What was it? Display this. Why? Where is it? Topic. So this thing? There it is. He said, look at that. When the smiley is sad, I'm sad as well. Can it be that hard to look up some documentation? And of course that doesn't work, but we know where it is, I think. Hello pi, include. That one maybe. Oh, that's tiny interfaces. Interface. Where is he? Here he is. What were we looking for? This man X element at. Oh, is that X for X window? To add something to X? Is that actually X running? Oh, who knows? Element at. Element. Add. Element change layer, element this and that. I think it's this. PC Disman X. Yes. Okay, this one has no comments, but it has VC Disman X Alpha T. And it's actually a pointer to that. This one is actually kind of one of those. And not an integer at all. But that's okay in C. So you see. Where is that? Struct. Defined. Let's Google that. Maybe that will work better. And when I say I Google that, I don't mean I actually Google that. I'll DuckDuckGo that, which is a default search thing in this browser. Which is kind of nice. There is a link in the chat, but the chat is running on another computer and I can't copy and paste. What do I type it? Let's have a look at this first. Alpha. Pointer to Alpha. Let's try it. Zero, or maybe something in the middle. This man X flex alpha T. Pretty. We have to look it up, but where is it hidden? Nowhere. Somewhere. Discman types. Discman X flex alpha T. Is this it? Flex alpha T. Yes. Why doesn't this? Did I? No. I don't know. Alpha fixed all pixels. Alpha fixed exceed. Alpha from source would be okay, I guess. Let's look this one up. This one. No. This one it is. Yeah, it's what? Does this even make sense? Discman X alpha T gets here it is. Opacity is okay. Discman X resource handle T, but that's not what he says. And what is this? Great. Mask. search, like next. Aha, it's an integer, which didn't work. But what are you trying to tell me? Can I see that in more detail? He's trying to tell me I need to initialize a little more than that, I think. Is that it? This man x flex alpha t, but where does it come from? This one. Does that make any sense? No, I think my computer's broken. Let's do something else then. Let's do this. Alpha dot flex. Flex is this crap. Alpha dot opacity is this one. And what was it? Alpha dot mask. Alpha dot mask. And now, does it build? It does not. Aha! It just showed me the wrong line. That's the whole problem. Programming could be so easy if the compiler just showed the right line numbers. Okay, let's see what happens. It works! And I get some messages. That's nice. I can actually maybe. Can I still interact with? That's nice. How can I? And it's still here. That is nice. Completely stupid, but nice. I like it. That's how I'll continue to work. With a partly transparent overlay. Some hints in the chat. Yes. Okay. So we have OpenGL running, I guess, and we can debug stuff, but it does not yet display our excellent red triangle, which I set up here. So, but much, much better situation now. We can context switch from minus 1 to 0. What is that message? Core system. There, nice. Debugging works. Can I? Let's try to set a breakpoint. Let's get crazy. Okay, that. Doesn't he call this? Hello, hello? Did we just maybe find our problem? Again, breakpoint here. No, breakpoints are just not working. That's sad. Why is that not working? feels like Android development. Really not working. Let's put a breakpoint here. No. Oh. Always makes me really sad when breakpoints don't work. Makes everything so much more time consuming. Anyway, let's use good old printf debugging. Don't we like that? I think we do. Printf. No, not print G, printf. Update. What do we have to pull in for printf? Do we have it already? No. Is that stdlib? Maybe. Super complicated stuff now. Yeah. What is it? Is it stdio? Yes, maybe, maybe. There you go. Update is called. And this context switch call and context clear call, those are called every frame, which seems okay, I guess. Okay. We're getting a little information out of our program, which is nice. Let's see if the buffer switch call actually happens. Where was it? Here somewhere. Handle messages. Do I have to do anything here? We will check that in a moment. Yes, that's called as well. All that stuff, it's not looking that bad. Probably just one tiny mistake or something. But what is it? We have no protection. We don't need protection. But this code kind of has to work because I just copied it. Didn't I? Maybe. Core system context clear. Yeah, okay. Ndebug is a Windows thing. Very much. As far as I know. Don't care. Clear current. Clear current. Clear current. What is that? Did I write that? I don't think so. Let's try something. No. But let's look it up. That was a very small jump in the source code file. Make current doesn't do anything. Yeah. Do we need that? I don't think so. Okay, let's get back to some working demo code and see if there's refine something in here that maybe looks useful that we didn't copy. We copied the complete init OGL code apart from this, but we called those anyway somewhere else. We shouldn't ever have to copy any OpenGL code from here because we have our own OpenGL code, which should work fine, and we didn't get any OpenGL. I have an interesting idea. I have an idea. It's a big secret. Maybe the OpenGL error messages are not activated. Because the thing about this code here is it's really slow. Slows down your OpenGL stuff. Aha! Now, if I could set a breakpoint in here, I would immediately know where that error came from. But I can't. Need a new strategy. Where's here? Invalid value. Error code 1280. Let's look that up. Error 1280. Invalid enum. So that's probably just some tiny thing that's not working. That's not me. I'm not in Sweden. I'm in Sweden next month for a few days, but not now. Okay, invalid enum. That can just be anything. What do I do? Do I litter my code with? Okay, we will do something fancy. Can we rewrite GL check errors? So it's a macro, and then we can use some other macro to get the file and line number. Can we do that? Maybe. Probably. Maybe. Where's that declared anyway? Declaration. Aha. Haha. Isn't it cute? Okay, let's try that. How does that work? We need this one. This one. Something like this. Macros. Hex macros are nice. C macros, not so much. Define GL check errors. A macro can take parameters, but normally it does not just take no parameters. Can that work with that syntax? Probably not. We will try. Use a an empty macro for now, just to see that if it works at all. You are out. Okay, compile. It compiles? Does it? Does it? Did it compile? What are those warnings? Control reaches end of... who cares? There will be... I like this warning. But it compiled. So we can actually build our macro. This means we have to take this code and let's just put it all in one line so we don't need those. Yeah, do we have clue? Don't think so. Oh, just wrong key. Wrong key again. This one. Printf. GL error. And let's get a line number. Oh, can we? We can put in the line number here, maybe, maybe, and some macro. See line number macro. Those things exist, but I don't think they are standardized, or are they? File and line. Ah, that's nice. Exactly what we need. Percent S, percent I or D. I'll take D, make it the same. Percent S for string, percent I or D, I think work both for integers. What do you think? Will this work? We should do this to put it in its own wrong key, in its own scope. Might just work, right? Right? I compile. Oh. 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 Include stdio.h. Compiles. And it compiles. And it links. And it has some warnings. We don't care about warnings. Nobody does. Let's start it. Vertex buffer impl line 168. I think I'll keep this macro. It's cool. Vertex buffer. What's happening? What was the line? 168? I think. Is it that big? It is. Ah. Do we even need that? Normally not. Hmm. 4, 3, 4. Wrong file. 4, 3, 4. Hmm. Oh, that is stupid, because that means the actual error happened somewhere where we forgot to put our GL check errors, which I normally put after every stupid GL call, because error management in OpenGL works like that. Check, check, check. Let's check everything. Do we even call that? I don't think so, but who was that? Wasn't me, I think, maybe. I don't know. Don't take away the error checks. Super important in OpenGL. Without error checking, you fly blindly. Check, check, check. Check, check. Oh, that's new stuff. But it's unchecked. Check. Check. Check, 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 check. Check. Okay. Why the hell not? Let's check. Two warnings. Same line, right? 4, 3, 4. Where is it? Check, 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 check. Check, check, check. All checked. Check, 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 check. Check. We don't call that much anyway. Has to be something that's called all the time, right? Check. Does it even compile? Of course not. But let's check. Yeah. Let's remove the hack. Or maybe. Maybe here. If not here, it has to be in here. Binary search. Not here. It's in draw indexed vertices. It seems. Why that? What happens here? Okay. Okay, somebody forgot about this one, which should now be triggered. And it is. And what is the problem? Do we need to use unsigned short indices like in Android? Maybe. And it told something about what's the error code? Error code. GL error. Code. Let's compile a little. How do normal people debug this? Normal people don't use computers. That was a question in the chat. 1280. We know that. Invalid enum. Let's try what Android does. What we do for Android. And we will also do that in here somewhere. This is Android. Yeah. So normally Core uses 32-bit indices for its models, but Android doesn't like that. So we work around that. Might someday do something less ugly for that, maybe. But for now, let's ifdef everything until everything runs. Do I need to add that in the header as well? Maybe. Upwards, downwards. That's backends, OpenGL, core, index buffer. Aha. Okay. What will happen? Oh, why does it? Okay, that is not. Sorry, this is not how you write an OR in a macro. You write instead defined parentheses open closed defined. This is how you do it. I'm sorry. Hope your children didn't see it. Don't tell your neighbors I did that. Defined. Or define this. Okay. See, you should watch your warnings actually, sometimes. Most of the time. And this one. Don't know. Maybe it would have worked anyway, but it's not correct C code. And when the syntax is not correct, some compilers are fine with that in some cases and some are not. And here. Okay. Was that everything? Did I create macros like that somewhere else too? Maybe. I'll find out someday. Compiled. I almost fell asleep for a moment while it compiled. No errors, but no red triangle. That is a shame. But no errors. It's always a very sad moment when you get no errors and still nothing works. But happens all the time when you work with 3D graphics APIs. The black screen. Always the black screen. What else can we do? Why is it still black? But reports no errors. What is wrong with my computer? Looks all fine. Little test. If we clear to something else than black, does that at least work? Where's my clear function? So much code. Who wrote all of that? I don't know. Browsing code. Here it is. Let's say we want whatever. What does it even? Floats from 0 to 1, I guess. GL clear color. Red. Green. Let's set alpha to 1. Might be, that might actually be helpful. Maybe. Doesn't work so great, does it? I don't see anything red. That at least normally works, because you just... Normally you can always clear your screen to a color in OpenGL, or in just about any 3D API for that matter. So let's... Don't do that. So the problem is not really about our OpenGL code, it seems. Just some random nonsense. I don't know. Why does it not clear the screen? I just want to clear the screen. It's my screen, right? I should be allowed to clear my screen. Let's do away with those. No red. Where's my red? Let's not use alpha for a moment, just to see if it is red or not. I don't like it. Put our cool alpha thing back in. GL clear color. GL clear color. GL clear color. Maybe we should actually... Okay, that was by fault. I'm sorry. Let's remember to change that back later. So graphics clear in core takes a flex integer, which tells what to clear. And if it's zero, it doesn't do anything, which means this call makes no sense at all. Why did I have a black, always have a black background anyway? I don't know. But maybe, look at that. All red. Something at least. OpenGL kind of seems to work. Let's make it blue, because we won't see a red triangle on a red screen, I guess. That's not blue, but good enough for me. Yeah, RGB. I should know that by now. Okay. Getting something at least. So. How did that happen? Why is it working now? Oh, it's a red triangle. Finally. Beautiful, right? Best triangle I've seen today. Okay. We got some rendering going on. Vertex buffers are working. Index buffers are working. Drawing is working. Shaders are working. You know, when this sample works, almost everything works. Everything but textures, but guess they will work too. Okay, but I still don't know why it now works and didn't work before. So before we didn't actually clear anything. Maybe Pi doesn't like it when we don't clear the frame buffer and does something stupid, like not working at all. Maybe. Maybe. I don't know. We keep that around for now. And we use this one. In this clear call. I think that's in the core namespace. Maybe not. Maybe it's, I don't know, where is it? Maybe in the core graphics namespace. Who knows? Yeah. Okay, so on Pi, you have to clear your screen, or else nothing works. Or does it? Let's not clear the screen again. And it now works too for some reason. I don't. Does that? Is it this? No. What did I change? What did I even change? I don't know. How did I make it work? Is it? Does it depend on the time of day? And where's my text cursor? Okay. Can fix that at least. But why didn't that work? I don't know. Anybody an idea? Hmm. still working. I don't know what happened. Isn't that the exact code I had before? And when it... I put in the original code had a zero here. Works too for some reason. I don't understand computers. Complicated stuff. Triangles sometimes show up, sometimes they don't. But one good thing, we have a video of the whole procedure and I can watch that later to see what changed, what I did, what I even did here. Should maybe always make a video. Maybe that will solve the mystery. But it works. I like it. So, what did we change? Status. Some stuff. Okay, and now, what do we do now? We should check out the texture sample, right? I'll check in what happened here. Fix the clear call, because that was just wrong. Okay. And something we should do. We should put all the options we set manually in here in core make. Because else things are getting annoying, a little annoying. Dip. Tools, comic. I think the linked libraries for Linux are still hacked into the actual exporter. Do we see them? Here they are. Look at that. Should change that someday. Platform. Is that what I think it is? Okay, let's not work on this file. Let's instead go to our texture sample, update core. Update core make in here and see and update it until that one works. Texture. Pull all the stuff. Okay. Core make code blocks exporter code blocks. I mean, so get the platform parameter. Does that maybe have? Pi set. Let's check. That's in main, I think. Yes. Oh, hier. Platform. That. Hier. Next. Platform. Support Project. Some asynchronous stuff. Super complicated. Options target. Becomes target becomes platform. Yeah. Makes not that much sense, but whatever. Platform. Platform. If platform platform dot py, it looks like this, maybe we will find out soon enough. Where's my hello? My cursor is gone here. What is happening? Oh, I think the pi is a little slow right now. Computers, they don't work. Let's save. Let's close it and open it again. My text cursor is back. Excellent. Okay. Else, this stuff. And if you remember, for the pi, we also had to add some include directories. We will have a look at the code blocks file in a moment to see where those are actually added. Or maybe we can get an idea about that already. Probably in the compiler something. We will see. Okay. Add some other stuff. How many do we need? We need, wrong window, 4. 4 of them. Oh my. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we need DL. Probably, maybe, GLESV2. ESV2. We need, oh, no, not this one. EGL. And one more, BCM host. BCM host. That is that. And now let's peek into the file. It's all saved here. Save everything. Up, 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 up. Down, down. So can I? Haha. Okay. That is how you reverse engineer an IDE project file. You change some little stuff and then you open it up and look into it. And when I think about it, the include problem, we already have include support. The problem was we hadn't support for adding global includes because I didn't have to do that for any other target, I think. Did I? Maybe. I don't know. Oh, we have some of that stuff in the Apple thing, I think, or maybe not. Hmm. Let's close some old stuff because I'm getting confused. Yeah, got all of that working. Include DS, yes, here it is. So we just have to do. Ah, to absolute path. Do we have more of that somewhere else? Find next. No. So we just have to fix this line. If ink.starts with, I think we can do that now in JavaScript. This one. Then we do something and else we do this. And what do we do? I guess we just paste it in. Like this? Maybe. Let's try. Our node is here. Core make pi. No error. That's nice. Let's have a peek into the generated file. Build, texture test, text editor. So. Okay. This looks all right. And our includes. We didn't yet add them to the core file. That's one problem. But where are they anyway? How do they look? Add directory. Add directory. Here, those are our includes. Okay. Core file. Not this core file. This core file. But when I close that and open it again, it maybe remembers last. Remembers the window size of the last instance of the program I closed. Makes sense. Somehow. Somewhat. Oh, we already have this one. And we didn't even. We maybe didn't even have to do anything but this. Let's try. Let's not do this for a moment. Let's see. This one. Rebuild. Not this one. This one. Did it update? Probably doesn't do that. Build text editor. Look at that. It already worked. Okay. That code was fine. We just have to add what we have to add. What do we have to add? We have to add. This, can I edit? Copy. Core file. this one. This one. Okay. Cancel. Let's keep it open for now. Can I open another instance? Maybe like this. Maybe not. Yes. No. Why should I? Fresh instance. Let's be safe. Compile. One error, he compiled the clue C file, which we took out. And we have a problem with our include files. So something ended up being different. Like it only added this one. Did I not save the file? What happened? Did I not? Core file. I did. Did I not rebuild it? Is that the problem? I think it is. Might just be. Here. Yes, that looks much better. But we have to exclude this one, because it's an evil file and a big file, and we can do that in core make. Don't know if I still remember how to do it. Let's see. Add exclude, something like this. Oh, I think this one did exactly the same thing. This here is the mscripten backend, by the way. Okay. Next try. Yes. Build it. Build everything. If this one works, we will try Tetris. But it doesn't. Oh no. This is a new thing. We had to add a directory for the libs. This is actually a new thing, and I'll just hack it in. Is this? Yes. Where is it? It's hidden here somewhere. Is this even the right file? No. It's not. What is this file? Looks like a Linux build. I didn't delete the file, did I? Cannot be. Oh, here it is. Or is it? Why is that just one? Ah, this is the thing. This is what we need. Add directory, but not in the compiler section, in the linker section. Makes sense. Do we still have something open? No. Back to the new one. Core. No. Yes. Comic. Code blocks. I later also have to update the exporter makefile, so it also works with the Pi. We don't even have to add a new if block. Isn't that nice? There you go. Okay. This number, by the way, is the indentation. Very important. Not really, but makes it look nice. Again. Okay. Like this, and like this, and like this. And now we test before we close the file. And yes, and compile, please. Okay. I'll try. Look at it. It's half of a parrot. And it's a hyacinth macaw, the biggest parrot on this planet, at least. Okay, textures are working. Let's check it in. And then we check out some Tetris. We just changed Cormac. I think. Not really includes missing lips. Oh, we also changed in. Change core because core file is part of core. Edit missing lips. When exporting for Pi, push it. All of it. Okay. Blocks, but first the core version. Then the car version, maybe. Pull some stuff. Pi. Okay. Yeah, I don't care. This is done. This I keep open. Plugs. Oh, deinitializing plugins. It's still closing down code blocks. Because closing programs, very involved job. Takes a lot of time, or you can just do this. Here it goes again. Open this one, this one, this one. Let's compile. Lots of warnings, which I have to fix all of them sometime, because when you have lots of warnings, you don't see your actual warnings, and the sample is not yet updated. Okay, but we can do that. No application. Let's look into the shader example. Da-da-da-da. Because that one is small and we can see what's going on. Oh, still have that in there. Who cares? This stuff I need. Oh, wrong indentation. Oh my. I guess one is with tabs and one is with spaces. Happens. So, no. Blocks. Blocks. What size was it? T-t-t-t-t-t-t-t-t-t-t. Oh, okay. Let's keep it like this. Let's call back up. Update. Yeah, that's that. Let's do it exactly like it was before. Ta 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 ta. Start game. App start. App start is now, is now, is now. Core system start. They've removed the application object, which I think is a good thing. But I have to update the sample codes. Okay. Some key enumeration values not handled. This is now, I don't know, what is this? I guess it's in system somewhere. Let's open the header. Sources core system header window width system window width with you know what? Didn't we do that before? Or something else, I guess. System. Window width. System window width. Now for something completely different. System window height. Okay, Ah, oh, more of it. It never ends. Okay. Warnings, Warnings, Warnings. App. Where? This is the same thing. Or is it? App with. No, that would be. Did app width return the window width, or did it return always the width I put in at the start? Ah, let's think about this. This is the background, which should be. Let's do something else. I think it needs those, which are here, here. See, that happens when you accept pull requests. At some point, there's code you don't know. Or no, when I think about it, no. That really needs this. Right, minus yes. Needs the actual window size, which on mobile targets is different than usually different to what you initialized it with, because you can't change the size of your mobile phone. Not with C code, at least. Okay, is this it? Can we watch Tetris? We can't play. We didn't implement any input yet, and this. Who cares about mouse input in a Tetris game? We do, because we also want to make it run on mobile. This is also because of the multi-window support. The mouse handle now takes, I think, a new first parameter for the ID of the window where it actually happened. But we put it in and ignore it. Compiled? Did it? Yes. 817 warnings. Not much of a problem. Look at that. We have some Tetris going on. It's looking good. It's running at the right speed. And I really like the overlay effect. I'll keep it like that. It's funny. Okay, Tetris works. Let's maybe try to implement controls. Can that be hard? Is that controls? Do I use usual X window stuff for that then, after all, maybe? How does that work? How do I even, when there's not really a window, how do I get input focus? I don't know. Is there something in the samples, maybe? Or maybe we could, okay, did we change anything to core? No, we didn't. We just updated the sample code. We will check that in, and then we will see whether car actually works. And because that will take a little while to compile, and while that compiles, we will look up how to add input. Okay. Modified content Y. Ah, we did change something after all. And I know what it was. Wasn't a big thing, but it's a change. Push it. We did not commit anything. Okay, let's do some car. Little change to CarMake. One moment. Really, really tiny change. It has to know about the Pi. Tools, CarMake. Options. Where is it? Here it is. Looks similar to the core file of the same name, the file in core of the same name. Empty backend, by the way, I use it to create the online documentation. That's it, I think. Do I switch based on? Oh yes, yeah. I think I need one other thing. Yeah, I need to add it here. So it compiles the shaders to the right language. But I think this is it, maybe. Android default, yes, by default creates a core project. So it might actually work, maybe. Let's try. CarMake Pi. Oh, what's that? Syntax error, word unexpected. I know what to do. I know just the thing. That's a simple thing. Here it is. You've seen that file before. I copy the other file. Car core tools comic evil code duplication. Yes. And now it looks better. No. Let's delete that one just to be sure. Yes. That looks better. Py project files. Okay. We still have. I'll open it up again. I don't trust that program because it always asks me stupid questions. Okay. And it doesn't manage to close down. Okay. Ah, that's now here, yes. Okay, this will take a while. But maybe it will work. And in the meantime, let's try to find out how to do input in a Py OpenGL application, if that even works. Blah blah. Triangle, yes. But how do I do anything with this triangle? Nobody knows. ES main loop. Get time of day. Okay, I do that too. No, not helping. Ugh, we don't use that. Can we do interactive 3D applications on the Pi, or can we only do slideshows? Can the Disp man help us? This man, update, submit, sync. Not seeing anything about it. Aha, this man X is in the process of being deprecated. We did all of it for nothing. Is still used in all API demos and its replacement may not yet be available. Yeah, internet is cool. in favor of this, or maybe not. Excellent, excellent. The demos, where was there anything? Where are the demos? Hello, Pi. Hello, audio. Oh, that is interesting. But we won't do this today because it's already late. But that's nice. We know where to look up stuff. And is that Alza? I don't think so. Audio plate state T. That's kind of looks like all the other Pi stuff we've seen. Clog. OXM audio param PCM mode type. Whatever. IL client set empty buffer done call, of course. I don't think this is ALSA. OMX is for Open Max, right? Which is this video thing? Okay. OMX buffer header. But is this the thing to use? Maybe. Maybe or maybe not. What else do we have? Hello, encode. Hello, this man X. Hello. Hello, tiger. Read me. Yeah, that doesn't help. It said something at the top. What said something at the top? This thing? Or this thing? No. Or the audio thing? Did this say something? Audio output demo using OpenMax IL. Though I think here's one letter missing. Through the IL client helper library. I don't need no helper libraries. Or do I? I don't think I need them. Aha. Oho. Okay, that is using OpenMax for pure audio. Looks like it's just putting some audio in there, which is just the thing we need. So I guess we will use that. Don't know if I even can record audio as I have it set up now. Still, how do I get input and what is going on here? Get PID is not working and what? Oh. That is HXCPP, not compiling for some reason. But who cares about this? I think that was me because of the same problem. SysLinux is defined, we should change that. Anyway. So much stuff to compile. About the audio thing, yes. Seen it. Still no idea how to add input. Maybe they just didn't think about that. Writing IL clients, whatever that is. IL, what is IL? This whole diagram tells me nothing about things like keyboard input. I would guess I'll have to use X-Window after all for that part. But how do I grab the keyboard if I'm not running in a window that the user can click? How do I do that? Can I do that? And this one is still compiling. Then have a look at our X-Window input code. Car, core, backends, Linux. That's, I think that's in here. That looks like keyboard code. Handle messages, X. Okay. And yeah. Okay, I can probably paste that in, but how to get focus? Because this will not work. Also, this is some X thing, which I don't have really, which is probably the display, which probably, yeah, later represents the window. And we have some indentation problems because tabs and spaces. X open display. Do we do something stupid like putting a window, a full screen window beneath? Yeah, like we could open X window just to get input and render on top of that. And probably that's the way to go because nobody thinks about that. I mean, who needs input? Only those weird game developers, or what do I know? Yeah, that's stupid. So we create an X display thing. We don't call that OpenGL stuff. We call X create window. Yeah. Makes me remember some stuff I did about 10 years ago. For hardware accelerated 3D graphics inside WinUAA, which is an Amiga emulator. I had to do the same thing because I put the 3D stuff on top from the outside. So I created a window inside the operating system, moved it around, and put some 3D stuff on top. Didn't expect that to do that in an actual non-emulated operating system thing. Looks like we have to. Anybody got any other idea about that? And how long will it really take to compile this? I think this compile is actually slowed down by all the printing of all those warnings, which is really slow, as you can see inside code blocks. Okay, when input is that complicated, then I think I'll do another stream, maybe next weekend or the weekend after next weekend, to do input and audio. Is that okay for everybody? Because we're already streaming 4 hours almost. And when I upload a video file of 4 hours length, I think YouTube will just crash. And when YouTube crashes, and it's my fault, I don't know what will happen. Maybe I have to go to Africa and nobody finds me. And it's still compiling. Compiling, compiling. Okay, looks like that's what we are going to do. So we will see whether blocks for car works or not. And then we will be done for today and finish audio and input in the next stream. And it's compiling, and it's compiling. Still compiling. What do we do in the meanwhile? Can't watch the compile window all the time, can we? Could start Minecraft again, but then I would probably slow down the compilation. Funny idea. Maybe it will work faster when I hide it because it doesn't have to print the warnings, but probably not. Can't find out anyway. So much source to compile. Where did it all come from? A progress bar would be awesome. We don't get that. C programmers don't have that. It's not possible. Actually, it is. Very much. Not here though. Let's just Google some more. Maybe we'll find something else about input. Did I put in any? Let's search for Raspberry Pi OpenGL keyboard. Okay, we can order a keyboard for the Pi. Won't help us. Keyboard. Keyboard events? What's that? Da, 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 da. I don't see no keyboard. It's using cookies. Is that even legal? I don't think so. He will be using SDL. That's not cool. Noob. No, not helpful. EGL window class. Might that be helpful? Do we have that? What is an EGL window? What does it do? Probably nothing, because EGL is nothing Py specific. Guess just a connection to an actual window. EGL create window surface. Yeah. That won't help us. No. Without X windows. Isn't this what we had before? Isn't this the same as this? Look at that. Small world. I see something about a keyboard. Keyboard. No, this is the key setup. Oh, it's a sad smiley again. No, not helpful. Ah, ask the chat for questions. Excellent. What's planned next for car? Next thing is finishing Vulkan support. I still have a problem with render targets. Don't know why or what, or but yeah, you know, that's similar to our red triangle problem from earlier. We'll probably end up being something like that, where I in the end don't even know what I did wrong. But then that's finished and we have kind of full Vulkan support, which is nice, I guess. And then I want to add some audio fixes. That's the stuff I already told. Then I want to get out a new version for Hexlib and a new version of CodeStudio with some small updates. And then what will I do then? Then I can do everything. There's some more fancy stuff I want to do until WWX in Paris in May. And if it works, I want to take all my work holidays in the month before that, so I can do fancy stuff. And we just have 7,990 warnings, and it took us 13 minutes to compile. Oy, oy, oy. Run. Oh, render target problem. Did we? Why? Error 1280 again. Render target impl line 50. Good thing we have that macro set up. Qua backend. So still something to do. I think we'll make a 10-hour streaming session until all the graphics are working. Hello. Render target impl. Ah, it's that stuff again. Hey, I was here already. Why is this? This is just taking care of the depth buffer. And maybe this is actually the thing which was reported yesterday, which also isn't working on iOS. But I don't need a depth buffer for Tetris. Not really. Is car hex 3.3 ready? Oh yes, I think so. I recently compiled that to check out the new HL target, and it at least compiled my code. So I wanted to do, actually that's something I will probably do before the next Hexlib and Code Studio release, compiling a new version of Hex, because there was a fix for JavaScript debugging, which is kind of important for Code Studio. So I probably take that. And when I compile a new version of Hex, I probably also update the HXCPP version car uses. Yeah. So that will probably happen. Compiled. It's Tetris. It's working. Ah, I tried to play it, but we don't have controls. Okay, Tetris is working. This piece of code is not working, but that I think I'll do outside of the stream. Doesn't seem Pi specific at all. And is some OpenGL code I didn't write and have to understand first. Yeah, I'll do that outside of the stream. But apart from this piece of code, car now runs on Pi, without input, without audio. But we'll get that done too. Okay, I think that's it for today. Any more questions? If not, I'll shut down the computer for today, and we'll have another stream soon to implement audio and input for the Pi. Okay with everybody? So now I have to wait a minute for the stream to catch up, so somebody can actually... Ah, another question. Any plans for fonts to support other languages? Yeah. Didn't we talk about that? Yes, we did. Ah. Somebody is mocking me. Yes, but to have it in the stream. Since a few months, car can render fonts itself at runtime using a hex port of STB TrueType, and it still doesn't support Unicode fonts really, because it always creates a bitmap of just the first 200 clues in the font file. And I want to solve that by just extending the API a little, so you can set what part of your clues in the font file is rendered to your bitmap font at runtime. So you can create the proper bitmap at runtime based on your language settings. Okay, I close it down for now. So I'll see you soon again. We'll announce when that will happen. So in 1 or 2 weeks, I guess. So goodbye.